Hello, everybody. My name is Oksana Parfenyuk. I am a Ukrainian photographer who is based in Kyiv. I work mostly with international publications like the Washington Post, NBC News, Liberation, and many others, and cover all kinds of different news happening here in Ukraine.
Hi, everyone. My name is Serhiy Korovaini, and I'm a photographer and a Fulbright scholar. Thanks for this opportunity to show again more photographs, visual stories from Ukraine, and I truly believe that more people will feel, more people will see and understand what's going on in Ukraine, that war is far from over, that our people are still struggling, that we still need your support, and we are tremendously grateful for your support, and this cruel and unnecessary war will end soon.
This exhibit really, really has evolved over the past year in different locations, different conversations, as well as different events that have been ongoing in Ukraine, in which the photographers are working every day. War and Resistance, our title, really underlines our wish for this war to end and for justice and full sovereignty of Ukraine to define the future of the 21st century in Europe and in the transatlantic relationship.
My name is Brendan Hoffman. I'm a photographer based here in Ukraine. Me, Fulbright, stands for education, it stands for knowledge, it stands for exchange of information between cultures. I'm American, but I've been here for nearly 10 years, working primarily for the New York Times, but also many other international media covering the war here, life in Ukraine, Eastern Ukraine, and other news stories.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Jen, or JT Blatty. I'm a United States combat veteran of Afghanistan and Iraq, and a photojournalist and writer. I have been working in Ukraine since 2018. I first came there very drawn to soldiers and veterans and the familiarity of war and wanting to incorporate it into my work. But I found something much more inspiring, which was the 2014 volunteer soldiers of the conflict in eastern Ukraine, who in 2014 self-deployed without a contract, without pay, of their own free will to fight for something that came from within in their own border.
You know, there is a war in Ukraine, of course, for almost 10 years now, but then with the full-scale invasion, it is incredibly important for the world to know what is going on. But of course, each of us having a different background, different story, different cultural and social upbringing, we, of course, each of us brings in something to a photo that someone else doesn't. I like to photograph more intimate stories, and I, for my photos to have this feel that you would be immersed in someone else's life and their emotion.
I'm trying my best for the 10 years of this war, because war started from 2014 when Russia invaded annexed Crimea and invaded my homeland, my region of Donbas in eastern Ukraine, and especially for these 2 years of the full-scale invasion, as we name it, to photograph as many experiences Ukrainians participate in, and sometimes those are really heartbreaking. People left without homes, people killed, civilians killed, soldiers killed, wounded, and sometimes reality here in Ukraine looks gloomy and very sad.
I think that primarily my goal in every story that I photograph is to try to add value to the discourse and the conversation that's happening. I want people to see something that they've never seen, or see something in a way that they've never seen, so that they can understand what is happening here in Ukraine and what life is like here in Ukraine, maybe in a more visceral way, in a deeper way than they've been able to before. So that usually means, primarily I'm trying to convey a mood with my pictures. There's factual information that needs to come through in a photograph, but just as important is to try to help people understand what it feels like to be here right now.
I would say that within my work, I'd like to bring attention to the human aspect of things and the personal, to really paint a portrait of the people and show you their eyes, make them real and not just skimmed over, you know, figures of casualties and injuries.
So this exhibition is also important to, you know, promote and protect and the freedom of speech, the free flow of information, and justice, social justice.
This exhibit is so important to continue traveling because right now we've gotten to that place where it feels like everyone has like Ukraine exhaust, especially in my own country. And we have to find a way to continually remind people that this isn't just, you know, this doesn't just affect Ukraine, it affects the world. And like I try to show you these people, these are the people that are paying the price for not only Ukraine's freedom, but for maybe other countries' freedoms around the world. And we cannot forget them and we must continue supporting them.
In my work, I'm trying to highlight that life is going on, that there is still light, hope, families, and something our soldiers are fighting for and unfortunately dying for. And that's probably my primary focus, to show that life is going on despite the war, and life will continue when war will end.
I really hope you all enjoy this, and thank you for listening.
Thanks everybody for watching our video. Sorry we can't be there in person, but I hope that the exhibition is informative and powerful.
Thank you.
Let peace arrive as soon as possible. Thanks again. Bye.